Yeah, I've learned from my colleagues across the state that have been doing this for quite a few years and kind of went through the process with them a couple of times, and the last several years been doing it on my own, but with help from others that were the nest site is. But yeah, it's a pretty quick and easy process once you've done it a couple of times. Kind of know the steps and know how to handle the birds and know what to expect.
Oh, I guess they're pretty gentle. I've banded owl's chicks before, spotted owl chicks, but it's been about 20 years since I've actually banded a raptor chick, and so it's pretty exciting. Sharp talons.
Wow! That's painful.
Catch you good?
Yep.
Oh, this guy's much smaller.
It's much smaller. I don't know if it's because it's the... much sharper, too.
Yeah.
So we are tracking when they hatched because you have to wait for 28 to 30 days before you can put a band on. Because as you saw, the leg is actually really big. And that's why if anyone's looking at the video and they look like they have flub-a-dub feet in the nest box, because their legs are really the size they are as adults, even though they're not gonna fledge out of the box for another 4 weeks or so. You know, I think it actually starts with the students. They decided to do this. They built the box. They did everything. And the amount of enthusiasm that they put into this and dedication is really, I think, what a lot of people are drawn to. And it's an iconic bird. And it's a beautiful, it's the fastest bird on Earth. And I think it's really exciting that everyone gets to see it, especially those that are Spartans. It's really pretty special.